Adita Kasangaji, a mother of three, is an example of such couples married to a soldier that is HIV negative. The two received counseling from medical workers on how to use a condom and also take drugs as prescribed.
It's 5 years. Up to now, my husband is still negative and I'm still positive. And on top of that, because the doctor told us in the hospital that you have decided to marry this lady, he said that yes. What I want to encourage you, that gender-based violence at home, when you keep on fighting, the woman will end up affecting you on that fighting, because you will fight with her, she will run away and miss that day taking what? Medication. That you keep on assisting her to remind the times of what? Of taking medication.
One is positive, another one is negative, yet they are staying together and they are having sexual intercourse together. The reason is simple. Concerning CD4 cells, those CD4 cells, they have got what we call CD4 receptor surface. The virus, when it enters your body, it attaches itself to that receptor and it enters inside the cell and it starts multiplying. So people who are usually negative and they are having positive partners, they have CD4 cells, but they don't have the CD4 cell receptors. So in such incidents, you find that even if the virus enters this person's body, it can do what? It can't affect the cell.
Kasangaji says some people living with HIV have a problem of disclosure with fear of losing their loved ones, stigma and discrimination from the community.
The problem we have is disclosure, stigma and discrimination. Those three things. When we fight on disclosure, you tell your partner that your status, that person will decide himself that I will stay with you or not, instead of infecting someone without you knowing, and after him knowing, that person will kill you, and automatically you lose that family. Maybe you had children there, so you end up leaving children there. So very many things that comes on, most especially on disclosure. That's why we are putting more effort on disclosure. Then stigma, I mean discrimination, that one we are mostly encouraging our community members. If someone is HIV positive and you know he's HIV positive, please stop discriminating him or her.
A lot of stigma and discrimination among the communities. Taking an example, if a girl has dropped out of school and is not getting support and she wants to go and look for work as a house girl, we have gotten a number of people who are getting tested. The employer decides to test this girl unknowingly. She takes the girl to the health center or to someone to test, and if they find this girl positive, they will not give her a job. They have denied them jobs. They have discriminated them.
Kabarole District is currently struggling to extend services to HIV victims as a result of COVID-19 lockdown restrictions. According to a report released by Uganda HIV Impact Assessment, Kabarole and Fort Portal City rank 14% prevalence rate after Kalangala District. Story by Doreen Ninsima for the news in Fort Portal.